Hi friends, welcome to practice. For today's class, you might want a blanket somewhere in the middle of your mat if you like extra padding for your knees. If you don't need extra padding, then no preps are necessary. And we're gonna start standing today. So come to stand on your mat with your feet about underneath your hip bones. So not hip distance apart, but right underneath those bony piece parts at the front of your pelvis. Try to make sure the inside of your feet are parallel, your toes are not turning out or in. And then if it's comfortable, you bring your hands to your belly. If that doesn't feel good, you could rest your arms down by your sides, your hands at hips, whatever feels best. So start by just letting the eyes close if it feels all right, or maybe soften the gaze somewhere on the ground in front of you. Feel the connection of your feet pressing into the earth. And see if you can start by pressing into all four corners of your feet. So press into the big toe mounds, that padding below the big toes. Press into the pinky side of the foot. Press into your inner heel and your outer heel. And if you feel the inside of your foot collapsing, can you lift your inner arch as you press into the big toe mounds? And from all this rootedness in your feet, start to feel the crown of your head reach up, growing a little bit taller. Do that without shrugging your shoulders up. Relax the shoulders, the belly. Invite a slow, deep breath in through your nose. And let's take an open mouth, clearing breath out of the mouth. And now start to find a steady breath in and out of your nose if possible. And as you breathe in, maybe you feel your belly expand, sending the breath downward. As you exhale, maybe feel the belly gently draw back in towards center. So there's this sense of opening, feeling the body expand as you breathe in. And just feel the body kind of soften, settle, ground as you breathe out. And let's take another full cycle of breath here. Full inhale, full exhale, in and out of the nose. And then with your next breath in, let your eyes flutter open if they were closed, letting a little bit of light in. And then just relax your arms down by your sides. So we're gonna start by just warming up the wrists a little bit. Reach your arms forward. And then curl your fingers in, make fists with your hands. So we're on our hands quite a lot in yoga, and it's normal for your wrists to get a little tired or feel a little strained when you first start practicing. But I promise the more you practice, the more strength and mobility you're gonna increase in your wrists. Now, turn your knuckles up to face the ceiling. And what you just did was you extended at the wrist. And then from here, start to uncurl your fingers so that your fingers are pointing the ceiling as much as you can. It's like you're making a stop sign with your hand. And it's actually, believe it or not, harder to do this when your hands are not on the ground. Try to draw your fingers straight back towards your face as much as you can. And remember, in a plank, our wrist to the forearm has to be at a 90 degree angle. That's a lot, so that's why at first yoga can be a little bit uncomfortable for the wrists. So we're just gonna warm up the wrists a little bit. Now curl your fingers in and then start to aim your knuckles down towards the floor. This is flexion of the wrist. Aim down as much as you can. I'm feeling a nice stretch on the top of the wrist. Keep the fingers curled in, roll the knuckles up towards the ceiling, pause. Uncurl your fingers, spread them nice and wide. Try to draw your fingers back towards your face. Curl your fingers in, aim the knuckles down, flex, roll the knuckles down as much as you can. And then one more time. Roll the knuckles up towards the ceiling. Undo the fingers, spread them. Try to draw your fingers straight back towards your face. Extend at the wrist. And now pause as you extend at the wrist. Draw the fingers back. And now we're going to do some natural movements of the shoulders. I'll turn to the side. You can stay as you are. Start to press your hands as far forward as you can. So your shoulders are spreading across your back. This is protraction of the shoulders. And then keep your arms straight. Shrug your shoulders back into the socket. So the arms stay straight, the shoulders are just moving forwards and backwards. Push forward again, like you're pushing something away from you. And then shrug your shoulders back, and you might feel your shoulders press into the chest. So press forward, let's hold this one, like you're pushing something away from you. This is shoulder protraction, shoulder blades moving away from each other on your back. This is what we have to do in our tabletops, our planks, even our down dogs. Take another inhale And now exhale, draw the shoulders back and start to feel your shoulder blades coming towards each other. This is what we do more of in a back bend position. And now from here, you're gonna bend your elbows, bring your hands by the low ribs, bring your hands down so that your elbows are in line with your wrists. Squeeze your elbows in, draw the shoulders back. This is a back bend position. Take another breath, and then exhale, relax. Shake out your hands a little bit. Already a lot of work for the wrists. We're gonna do that one more time, just starting to feel a position of the planks in the back bends, feeling the shoulders move, and then we're gonna come onto our hands and knees. So reach your arms forward, extend at the wrist, turn your fingers up and pause. Protract your shoulders. Imagine you are pushing something away from you. Feel your shoulders spread across the back. This is what you want to feel in tabletop and plank. Take another inhale. Keep your hands as they are. As you exhale, start to bend at the elbows. And now, retract your shoulders. Draw the shoulders back. Start to feel your shoulder blades come into each other. Notice how your collarbones kind of widen. Can you do this without puffing the front ribs out? So can you draw these front ribs in, but continue to roll the shoulders back? One more breath like this. Exhale, relax your arms down by your sides. And now let's come into a tabletop on hands and knees. If you want your knees on that blanket, go for it. Bring your shoulders right over your wrists. Bring your hips right over your knees. Gently fan out your fingers. We're gonna take some cat-cows. As you inhale, start to curl your tailbone up towards the ceiling. Your pelvis is rocking forwards. Start to let the belly relax, your ribs puff out. Start to pull your heart forward and up, slide your shoulders back. This is your cow pose. You're in a position of extension in the spine. Take another breath in. Exhale, start to tuck the tailbone under, your pelvis rocks backwards. Lift the front ribs away from the floor. Push the ground away from you, round your upper back, shoulders spread across the back. Protract the shoulders like we just did. This is your cat pose. And then inhale, curl your tailbone up. Let the ribs drop, your belly relax. Press your shoulder blades into your chest, draw the heart forward and up. Cow pose. Maybe look forward, breathe in. Exhale, tuck the tailbone. Lift the pubic bone up towards the navel. Lift the low belly. Push the ground away from you. Feel the shoulders spread across the back. Maybe bring the chin into the chest. Cat pose. And then let's move on the breath a little bit. Inhale, arch your spine. Let the pelvis rock forwards. Belly relax. Heart lift. Exhale, round your spine. Pelvis rocks backwards. A little core engagement. Lift the low belly. Push the floor away from you. Inhale, one more time. Arch your spine. Extend at the spine. Maybe the gaze goes forward. Slide the shoulders back. Arms stay straight. Exhale, round your spine. Pelvis tips backwards. Low belly lifts. Round the spine. Push the floor away from you. Inhale, come back towards your tabletop. Turn your fingers out left and right and start to rock side to side here. This is a nice way to just kind of stretch out the wrist. Anytime you come onto your mat, feel free to do a little wrist warm-ups before you start, and I'll sprinkle in different exercises throughout our classes. And now from here, turn your fingers back forward. Walk your hands forward a big 2 to 3 inches ahead of the shoulders. Now, a very important factor whenever we're in tabletop, plank, or down dog is that you want your hands shoulder width apart with the creases of your wrists parallel to this top border of your mat. And oftentimes that means that your index fingers or your middle fingers are straight forward or somewhere in between. Rock forward, bring your shoulders over the wrists. So right now your knees are a little behind the hips. We're in this low plank position. Take a breath in. Exhale, round your spine like cat pose. Rock the pelvis backwards. Your tailbone tucks under. You're not in a back bend. Push the floor away from you. Shoulder protraction, shoulder spread across the back. Now, can you keep all this, but instead of rounding the upper back, start to pull your chest forward. Slide the shoulders away from the ears. Keep the gaze down, back of the neck long. So you're in one line from the crown of your head to your knees. No back bend in the lower body. Your core is engaged. Your upper body's engaged. Push the floor away from you. Take one more inhale. As you exhale, you're going to start to bend your elbows. Try to lower your pelvis first, then the belly, and lastly the chest. Stretch your legs long and back. Slide your hands back a little bit so that your elbows are over the wrist rather than hands under the shoulders. Squeeze your elbows in. Shoulder retraction. Feel the shoulders spread, come in towards each other. And then using as little of your hand strength as little as possible, lift your head, your chest, your shoulders, low cobra position. Feet press down, press into every toenail. Try to lift your kneecaps, not the feet. That's going to engage the quadriceps. And then squeeze your elbows in. That's going to help to roll the shoulders away from the floor. So this is quite the opposite of a plank or tabletop. Shoulder blades pressing into the chest. Notice if you're leading with the chin. Drop the gaze slightly. One more breath in. Stay to exhale. Now you're going to use your upper body strength to press up onto all fours. Take an inhale. Exhale straight up. Push up all fours. Come back to your tabletop. Turn your fingers in, your palms up. Here's another wrist stretch. Start to curl your fingers in and out. Try to get every single finger to bend. And then come back to your tabletop. Shoulders over the wrist, hips over the knees. In your tabletop, we don't want a back bend in the lower body. So this right now is a position of my pelvis tipping forward. I'm in a back bend, which isn't a bad thing, but my core is not engaged, and that's not what we want for tabletop or plank. So from here, lift your frontal hip bones up towards the front ribs. It's almost like a cat tilt in the lower body. However, we don't need to be so extreme in tabletop and round the upper back. So can you keep the pelvis tipping backwards, but reach the chest forward, slide the shoulders back? It's really this hybrid of cat-cow. It makes the pose much more challenging because your core and your upper body's engaged. Stretch your right leg towards the back of the mat and lead from the inner thigh, float your foot off the mat. And now imagine that your morning cup of coffee or tea was on your low back. That's very precious. We don't want to spill it. So spin the right outer hip down. I don't care how high the right leg is. Notice if you went into a back bend, lift the frontal hip bones up towards the front ribs. Are your elbows bending? Push the floor away from you and then option to stay or come to left fingertips. Maybe reach the left arm forward. Let's hold. Keep pushing down with the bottom hand. Lift the front ribs away from the floor. Keep the gaze down, back of the neck long. One more inhale. Exhale, left hand down, right knee down. Come back to your tabletop. Okay, other side. From tabletop, stretch your left leg back. Lead from the inner thigh. Float your foot off the ground and pause. Are you going to spill that morning cup of coffee or tea? Are you opening the hip? Dial your left outer hip down. Did your elbows bend? Protract the shoulders. Push the floor away from you. Are you in a back bend? Hug the front ribs in. Keep the gaze steady and then maybe stay or maybe come to right fingertips. Maybe reach the right arm forward. Let's breathe. Keep the gaze down, back of the neck long. Can you straighten your back leg? Straighten the bottom arm. Push the floor away from you. One more breath. Exhale, right hand down. Left knee down, tabletop. Sit back on your heels if it feels okay. And just reach your arms forward. Curl your fingers in. Roll out the wrists. So I know a lot of tabletops and planks right now. These are really foundational poses in yoga. As you take these classes, we'll do lots of them, and they're truly some of the best poses to build strength in the body because you're building strength in the front body and the back body. And then draw circles in the other direction. And it's better to do a few really good tabletops or planks, like really good alignment, versus a lot where you're not really focused on the alignment, because then you're losing an opportunity to build strength in the body. Okay, so from here, come back onto hands and knees. This time, lower the forearms to the mat. We're gonna give the wrists a little break, and I'm gonna teach you one of my favorite poses to do to build strength in the body. It's a set of two poses, actually. We're gonna hold each one for about 30 seconds. The first one is a plank on the forearms. Look at your elbows as you lowered them, and make sure they're under your shoulders. You don't want them any wider because then it's gonna cause your shoulders to collapse and it's not gonna feel good. Pause here. Push the floor away from you. It's easy to kind of sink through the chest, but try your best to protract the shoulders, push the floor away from you. And then walk your knees back a little bit. So they're behind the hips, and pause. Take your pelvis and do a cat tilt, meaning tuck your tailbone under, lift the pubic bone up towards the navel so you're not in a back bend, but your core is engaged. This is a plank on the forearms with knees down. Honestly, I'm already feeling it in my upper body. Now we're gonna hold for 30 seconds. Option to stay, or from here, step your feet back, plank on the forearms. Plug into the ground with the balls of the feet, not the tippy toes, if you step back. If you lift your knees, straighten your legs, tops of thighs are lifted, but keep the tailbone heavy. Rock your pelvis backwards, cat tilt in the lower body. Push the floor away from you, protract the shoulders, reach your chest forward as you keep the gaze down, back of the neck long. One more inhale, exhale, lower down. All right, very good job. I'm out of breath. Point your toes, slide your hands back by your low ribs, elbows over their wrist. Oftentimes the hands want to be under the shoulders. Slide them back. It actually makes a 90 degree angle with your arms. Stretch the legs long and back. Press into your toenails, even your pinky toenails. Lift your kneecaps. And then make your hands as light as possible. Inhale, lift your head, chest, and shoulders. Drop the gaze slightly so the back of the neck is long. This is your low cobra position. It's such a great pose to balance the plank on the forearms, which is why I usually practice both or teach both. We'll do a plank and then a baby cobra. This pose strengthens your back muscles, which tend to get super tight and weak because we sit a lot, we hunch over. Try to squeeze your elbows in, lift the shoulders away from the floor. One more breath in. And now stay to exhale. Press into your hands. Try to press straight up onto all fours, tabletop. And then swing your feet around. You can move the blanket to the side and come to lay down on your back. Bend your knees, bring your feet to the ground. Bring your arms into a cactus shape with your palms up. As you lay down, notice if your chin is much higher than your forehead. If that's the case, whenever you lay down, it might be a good idea to place a blanket or a block under your head, but a blanket feels much nicer. So bring your feet as wide as the mat and just start to swish your legs side to side. And just getting into the hips a little bit. And bring your knees back towards center. Walk your feet in. Bring the soles of your feet together, your knees out wide. This is called supine bound angle pose, Supta Baddha Konasana in Sanskrit. If this feels super intense, feel free to grab a block or a couple pillows to place underneath each thigh. Allow the eyes to close or soften, and try to soften the space between the eyes. Move the bottom teeth away from the top teeth, relax the jaw. Rest the tongue very gently towards the roof of the mouth behind the top teeth, but not pushing against the top teeth. And then come back to that breathing pattern that we established at the start of class. Even out your inhales with your exhales. Try to breathe in and out of the nose. As you inhale, you might feel your belly expand. And as you exhale, feel the belly draw back in towards center. Feel this sense of opening as you breathe in. And the sense of grounding as you exhale. And take just a few more cycles of breath like this. And this is where I will leave you. I encourage you to stay in this shape for anywhere from 2 to 5 more minutes if you have. And together, bring your palms together and bring your thumbs to your third eye center, that space just between the eyebrows. Take a breath in through the nose. A gentle open mouth clearing breath. Thank you for practicing with me. Om Shanti, peace.